Hello and welcome to our new video about identification systems, ID systems. We are now today talking about barcodes. Barcodes are stripes, which are machine readable. The first barcodes were done in the 50s and so on, just to experiment, but in a broad scale they were in the end of the 60s at a company called Walmart, a huge trading company in America, which introduced those barcodes. And then in the 70s the universal product code in America, the European article numbers, were developed. This is now representing pretty much on every consumer product you have. This is the thing which is read at the supermarket, by the cashiers. And now I looked around in my room, just around me here, and looked up what we see. And I found several things. Look at this here. This packet. But this way. Here's some barcode. It's a pack of magnets. Here on this bag, some barcode. Here on this description, some barcode. Here on this little sheet, which was included in the item, I'm not even sure which item, a display adapter, it's written up there. Some barcode. Here at this back, some barcode. Here at the cover of my ruler, some barcode. I even found here, this one. There is barcode on this plug. It's just, power supply plug. Barcode. Then, here, look at that. At my portable drive, there is even printed on barcode. See? Barcode and the portable drive. Also interesting, this thing here, DVD writer. Look at that. Also barcode, made in China, with some different barcodes even. So you see the EN, or European article number, the UPC, the universal product code, and also some other barcode at the top. Portable DVD writer, three different codes. This already gives the impression, hey, there are different codes, and they are almost literally everywhere. Everywhere. Here, cable. Look at that. Cable. On the cable, a label with some barcodes. If you're getting a packet from your favorite online dealer, it is delivered. It has several barcodes on it. Here, barcode even in the product design of batteries. Also on the back, different or maybe the same barcode, I don't know. Barcodes are simply everywhere. And they are enabling us to identify those pieces. There's not a barcode the same. What is written, and how those patterns, dark and light patterns, might be interpreted, we're going to talk about in next videos, because there are different barcodes we have seen, especially on this. This thing here, we'll make a little bit more lightning here. Is it then better? Let's see. Yes, look at that. Now it's great.
A little shaky.
See? Three different type of barcodes on one box. So we're going to talk about this, about those different type of barcodes. You know? First barcode we're going to talk about in the next video is the code 39. Maybe some of those are code 39, I'm not sure. Then we're going to talk about code 128, which is replacing 39 is 3 of 9, 128. We'll see what this means, yeah, and how those lines are coding something, yeah, and why are the different things and how are they different, yeah. And then we are also talking about the interleaved, so-called interleaved codes and the European article number and so on, yeah. And let's see if we can try to decode something, maybe some barcode where we know the number, that we know we're doing it right. And we know that what I tell you is not just something. I'm planning to make a solid proof for that, okay? So barcodes. This is the topic of the next videos. Next time, code 3 of 9, or it's not a Borg number. I am 3 of 9. No, it's... We're talking about a code, okay? Barcode. Or short code 39. For this time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.